So dear students, today we are going to study this respiratory system of insects. Respiration first. In insects, the exchange of gases is carried out by complex tracheal system. The tracheal system is invaginated from integument. Then some types of the diphtherians larvae, the tracheal system is absent, and integument is serve as function of gaseous exchange. So respiration means exchange of oxygen and CO2. In insects, tracheal system is act as a respiration, and blood does not play any role in transport of gases, and blood cells, that is hemocytes, absence of respiratory pigment like hemoglobin or hemocyanin. Now the first A, the organ of respiration. Tracheal system, actually it is a ectodermal in origin, and integumental invaginations which develop repeatedly in lateral side of segments. From second thoracic segment up to this eighth abdominal segment, it leads towards the formation of external openings. Now that external openings are called as the spiracles or stigmata. Now then, classification of this respiratory or tracheal system. In most of these insects, the trachea communicates proximally to outside through spiracles, and while innervate the tissue of internal organs after being modified into as very fine branches. These branches are called as the tracheoles. Such type of tracheation which constitute open type of tracheal system. In immature aquatic insects, the spiracles remain closed, and absorption of O2 that will be takes place by the integument, means O2 from surrounding water, that is will be carried out, as well as integumentary structures that will be developed in aquatic insects. That structures are called as the gills, and then this type of system is called as a closed tracheal system. This open tracheal system and closed tracheal system. Then Kaelin is the name of scientist, and in turn they have proposed the scheme of classification of tracheal system on the basis of functional spiracles. Now first A, polynistic type of tracheal system. Now in it represents open tracheal system and can be divided into three subtypes. That subtypes are holonistic type of this tracheal system, hemionistic type of tracheal system, and perimnistic type of tracheal system. Holomnistic means it consists of all 10 pairs of spiracles are functional, and they are mostly found in nymphs and adults of hemimetabola order. Then hemionistic type of this tracheal system, in which only 8 pairs of spiracles, that is the mesothoracic and first 7 abdominal spiracles, are functional, whereas other pairs, they are non-functional. And this type of tracheal system is mostly found in a larvae. And third one is in polymnistic, that is a perimnistic type of tracheal system, in which 9 pairs of spiracles are functional. Only one single pair that will be located on metathorax, it is a non-functional. And this type of tracheal system is found in terrestrial larvae of Neuroptera, Lepidoptera, and Symphyta. Now then B, that is the oligonistic type of tracheal system. It represents partial open type of tracheal system. It is also further divided into 3 subtypes. That subtypes are amphinistic, metanistic, and proponistic. Amphinistic type of tracheal system, in which only 2 pairs of spiracles, that is a thoracic and last, this first thoracic and last abdominal spiracles, they are functional. And they are mostly found in a larvae of Diptera. Metanistic type of tracheal system, only one single pair of spiracle, that is the last abdominal spiracle, is a functional, and they are mostly found in a larvae of Typholidae hypoderma as well as the first instar larva of Cyclorapha as well as aquatic Coleopteran larvae. Third, proponistic type of tracheal system. It is recognized when only single pair of spiracle, that is the first pair of mesothoracic, is open. Example, pupae of Diptera. And then anistic type of, the third C, number C, that is anistic type of this tracheal system. Now in this type of tracheal system, it represents closed type of respiratory system. All pairs of spiracles are closed and non-functional. Oxygen is absorbed by integument or gills, and they are mostly found in aquatic and endoparasitic larvae. So then D, the hypoenergic type of tracheal system. It represents partially degenerated or a typical type of tracheal system in which one or two pairs of spiracles, they are disappear completely. And the insects which bears less than 10 pairs of spiracles, and they are found in a Malophaga and Siphonculata. In Siphonculata, one pair of thoracic spiracle and six pairs of abdominal spiracles. Then Thysanoptera, two pairs of thoracic spiracles and two pairs of abdominal spiracles. In Hemiptera, two pairs of spiracles. Then in Colembola, one pair of spiracles. In Cyclorapha, that is a five pairs of spiracles. And then last one in is E, hypermnestic type of tracheal system. Now it shows presence of more than standard number. Means 10 pairs of spiracles, this is a standard number. But more than these 10 pairs of spiracles, that is a hypermnestic type of tracheal system. And they are found in a dipleurula, which bears 4 pairs of spiracles are found in a thorax, and 7 pairs of spiracles found in a abdomen. This total 4 plus 7 is equal to 11 pairs of spiracles, that is a hypermnestic type of tracheal system. Now next, this is actually where spiracles are there and what is about this tracheal trunks they are present. Spiracles, they are present in a lateral side. These are the spiracle opening and they are present in the lateral side of this body. Means any insects, their body is made up of number of segments, but each segment is made up of dorsal terga, ventral sterna and lateral pleura. Now these spiracles, they are mostly found in a pleural region. This lateral region is a pleural region. And then here larvae, that is a lateral side of this larva, here made up of these spiracles. Actually body is made up of head, thorax, abdomen, thorax, that is a prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax, abdomen, that is a abdominal segments. Now in prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. Mesothorax spiracle, they are found in between prothorax and mesothorax, and metathorax spiracle is present in between mesothorax and metathorax. This is the position of the spiracle. Now here, animal body is made up of three parts, that is a dorsal part, there is a pericardial region, middle part perivisceral region, and ventral part, that is a perineural region. Pericardial region means what? The cavity is found in the outer side of this heart. There is a pericardial cavity. Then middle region, perivisceral, viscera, outside of this viscera. And perineural means outer side of this ventral nerve cord. And here in dorsal side, a pair of tracheal trunks are there. These are called as a dorsal tracheal trunks. Ventral side also, a pair of ventral longitudinal trunks. And then lateral longitudinal trunks, they are present in the lateral side. And then they are open into these spiracles. This is the outer opening. Here, visceral trachea, they are found in a region, in a viscera. Actually, they are comes from the lateral longitudinal trunks. which are divided into number of the branches, and these branches are innervated to these visceral organs. Now then next, the organ anatomical organization. The tracheal system is composed of two structures, internal tubular trachea and external structure that is called as spiracles, and they are initially developed segmentally, but later on they are fused intersegmentally to form a complex tracheal system. It consists of longitudinal trunks, transverse commissures, intercalated air sacs and terminal tracheoles. Now first, what is about the trachea? Now the trachea is the wall of trachea which shows similar but reversely organized structures of body wall, and which consists external basement membrane, and then middle epithelium, and inner one is a cuticular intima. The cuticular intima is divided into a series of rings, means like that trachea which contain the C-shaped type of rings similar to that type. Here series of rings are there, and they are forming a spiral coil or filament throughout the length of the trachea, except tracheolar region, and these parts are called as a tinidium. This tinidium prevents collapsing of the tracheal wall. Then in trachea, tracheal branches are there, trunks and commissures. In a pterygota, except Lepis metidae, trachea are long, unbranched and free tubules, while other insects, they undergoes branching or unification. But the proximal part of this trachea, which runs for short distance from the spiracle, and this part is called as a spiracular trachea. It gives out three branches, anterior, posterior and visceral, which constitute the dorsal, ventral and visceral. Dorsal, that is about this anterior, similar to, and posterior, that is a ventral, and middle one is a visceral. Then the spiracular trachea gives out lateral branches which fuse out with the structures that is about the neighboring segments, and they are called as the lateral longitudinal trunks. Similarly, fusion of dorsal, fusion of ventral and fusion of visceral, the results to formation of dorsal, ventral and visceral longitudinal trunks. In each segment, these paired trunks are transversely connected with each other by tracheal commissures. Then next part, that is about the air sacs. At various places, the trunks and commissures dilate into large air sacs, and which undergoes periodic contraction and expansion in order to accelerate the process of respiration or ventilation, and they provide buoyancy during the flight and may also function as a heat insulators. Then sound resonators or hydrostatic organ in aquatic insect. They are developed more in flies, wasps, bees, ants, dragonflies, as well as some beetles. Now then next, these tracheoles. The distal end of these branches of trachea, they penetrate the tissues, and these distal ends are called as the tracheoles, and they are a very simple structure, but they are branched fine capillaries or tubules, and they form within the cell, and they are known as the stellate cells. This tracheal end of the cells are called as a tracheoblast. There is no difference in basic the wall of trachea and tracheoles, except the cuticle layer, because it is a uniformly annular, thin and about half thickness, and absence of the chitin material or protein matrix. But they replaced by the one of the protein, that protein is called as a rubber protein. Instead of that, the protein is there, that protein is called as a resilin, and these tracheoles are intracellular in position, this trachea are reconstructed at each molt, but tracheoles remains unchanged. Then these spiracles. Spiracles they represent simply these spiracles. Various type of spiracles are there. That is a simple, atriate, bichambered, biferous, multiferous. Now they represent simply opening of internal trachea. In all the insects except Dipleurula, the spiracles are wanting from prothorax, and there are only 10 pairs of spiracles, one on each, that is a meso and metathorax, and other, that is about the abdominal, is total from 1 to 8, that is abdominal segments, and they are situated laterally on the pleural membrane. A pleural membrane means what? The pleura part is present. It is actually part of segment, lateral part of the segment. Dorsal part is called as a terga, ventral part sterna, and lateral pleura. Now then they vary widely in their structure and classified into different types. Now first one is a simple spiracle. Now in a simple spiracle, they are tubular and open directly from exterior to the lumen of trachea. An example, Thysanura. Second, atriate spiracle. Now this atriate spiracle, they are open first into cavity or tubular chamber, and that chamber is called as the atrium, which contain the sieve plates or hairs, as well as the peristigmatic glands, and it bears external openings, and these openings are called as the atrial orifice, which may be simple or provided with wall. Internal opening is called as a tracheal orifice, and the closing or occluding apparatus which develop external closing apparatus associated with atrial orifice. In thoracic atriate spiracle, and internal closing apparatus associated with tracheal aperture. In abdominal atriate spiracles, and they are found in a pterygota. Then number third type of these spiracles, they are bichambered spiracles. The spiracular cavity is divided into two chambers, anterior and posterior chamber. The posterior chamber is called as a occluding chamber. It bears internal closing apparatus, and they represents abdominal spiracles of ants. Now then, biferous spiracles. Now these spiracles bears two external openings which are secondarily developed while the primary atrial orifice is closed, and they occur in a larvae of Polyptera. Then multiferous spiracles, last one. Now these spiracles have more than two openings, and they are found in a third instar larvae of Diptera. In Glossina and Oestrus spiracles open exterior by 500 pores that will develop in a chitinous plate, and they remain open due to this absence of closing apparatus. Then next, mechanism of gaseous exchange. The gaseous exchange along with tracheal system, they can be divided into two parts: transport along the trachea and transport along the tracheoles. The transport along the trachea, most of the terrestrial insects, oxygen that we enter into tracheal system either through all or some of these spiracles, mostly by the diffusion mechanism, and this type of this mechanism is called as ear tube diffusion. Diffusion mechanism is very simple in small insects like the phlea, while others spiracles are provided with opening and closing of apparatus, and they control the rate of the diffusion. The diffusion control lies under the control of segmental respiratory as well as the sympathetic nerves, and which innervate these spiracles. Then oxygen, CO2 tension in blood, CO2 content of air that be taken. The spiracles remain open. This is also one of these control. Then CO2 tension is raised. The ventilation as a major supplementary mechanism, they occurs in a higher insects, because which initiate the sufficient uptake of this oxygen into the trachea, and they circulate through the tracheal system to various parts of this body. In higher insects, ventilation continuously force the gas to flow into the anterior posterior direction, is through the longitudinal trunks by pumping action of this abdomen. The pumping action is derived from elasticity of the body wall as well as this muscular activity of abdominal region, and they causes dorsoventral flattening structure, which is found in Hymenoptera, Diptera, Orthoptera and Coleoptera. Or peristaltic compress action, they are found in a tipula, but alternative movements of compression and expansion pumps, means that will be air out from and into the tracheal system through these spiracles. Air flow in and out of each spiracle, and such movement of air, that will be called as a tidal flow. Then respiratory cycle. The pumping action of the abdomen, which acts mechanically on the spiracular walls and the volume of trachea. As a result, air flow through these spiracles that we appear by the cyclic phenomenon. And the respiratory cycle is divided into also three phases, that inspiratory phase, compensatory phase and expiratory phase. Inspiratory phase is comparatively shorter than remaining two phases. In grasshopper, the inspiratory phase lasts for 1/4 second, while compensatory as well as respiratory phase each appear for 1 second, and collapsing the tracheal trunks as well as air sacs forces air out the tracheal system, while expansion sucks the air in again. The spiracles are closed for most of the time. Respiratory cycle is essential to avoid the water loss, and they are open only to supply the sufficient amount of oxygen to this system. Not all the spiracles take this inspiratory as well as expiratory phases, but specialized one of them. In locust, spiracles 1, 2 and 4, they carry the inspiration, and 10 which conduct the expiration in normal condition. But spiracles 5 to 10 serve during the more of, about at the time of the active expiration. Inspiratory spiracles open 20%, while expiratory spiracles open 5 to 10% of the cycle. And compensatory phase, that is last for 70 to 75%. And in honeybee, apis, that is spiracle only 1, and all abdominal spiracles conduct the inspiration, while spiracle 2, that will be carries the expiration. Then ventilation. In fast flying insects, abdominal ventilation is supplemented by pterothoracic spiracles, and third abdominal ganglion, which act as a pacemaker. Pacemaker means what? The heartbeat is originated from a specific region called as a pacemaker. Then abdominal ventilation supply about this 150 liters air, while the pterothoracic ventilation provides more, is 350 liters air. And O2 demand of flight muscles, which increases 400 times during the active flight. Cyclic release of this CO2, which occurs in a pupae, 90% of CO2 retained in tissues. But in a hylophora pupae, to burst this part, and CO2 may be of 7 hours. It occurs some diapausing larvae and pupa of Lepidoptera. Then some locust nymphs. During such type of condition, CO2 is absorbed in hemolymph and converted into the bicarbonate. Now this is about this part, or the remaining part that we see in next lecture. Thank you very much.